Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes. A Tear of Vermillion. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in Torkas Cave, searching for the Blowgun Bandits. Well, that's my name for them. They knocked out Avin and Maya last episode. Stole a couple of their things. Surprisingly, didn't steal everything. And we're now joined by Douglas, as of last episode, who's looking for them as well. They stole his special sword, given to him by his master? His trainer? Something like that. We're kind of over-leveled for these things, I guess. Poison beetle and beaten. Well, we haven't fought these things yet. The finishing move here on the beaten beat? Off the beaten path or something? Oh, I like this game. One-shotted, nice. Yeah! Missed. Didn't miss. Get rid of this thing first, it's easier, probably. Oh, good. Wow. I wasn't looking at Mile, I'm sure he got a lot too, but Avin, like, definitely saw Avin go way up with his leveling. As a result, of course, Douglas levels up a lot less quickly because he's level 14. Okay. Finishing move, I'm beating me. Sweet. It's almost not worth it to use these, because we're one-shotting them anyway. Then again, we can't miss with the finishing moves. Like that. Avin and Mile, yeah, about to level up. Sweet. Okay, dead end here. Alright, fine. Three of these things. I'm used to when you're here, and if you move over, going to the next one. Energy bullet, huh? Avin, level 9. And Mile, level 9 as well. Yay! Okay, that goes off the screen. Let me just come back to that. Oh, I like the effect with the water there. Okay, so we know up there is a dead end. There's one way off the screen. There's a bridge there. Don't need a rare potion. Oh, two chests. Nice. A raid boomerang. Tiresia H2O? Huh. Like some kind of modified water or something. Okay, it is ultimate potion made of shining stars. Literally. Restores hit points, magic points, status error completely. Wow. What about this, oh, it's gonna be under arms. Raid boomerang. Modified for maximum speed, the enemy has no time to reorganize. Huh, I wonder if that would be good for Mile. Speed goes up, but attack goes down. I don't want to sacrifice attack. I'm gonna not use it, at least for now. So here, oh, that's not where we came in. This is where we came in, isn't it? Yeah, unfortunately. Respawning the monsters now. Alright, so there's this bridge. There's another way to go. I didn't even mean to run into him, but I did. Yeah. I like this part. Yeah, a bit more of this and they'll get up to level 10 even a mile. Across the bridge of doom. Ah, oh, nice. Another antidote. Sweet. Alright, so there's one way off the screen. There's one way to advance. And that's back where we came and going north. It's not here. That's a dead end. Be useful, kitty. Be useful. Oh, nice. A Waroon sword? Ooh. What kind of sword is that? Has a brim that looks like a handguard. Seals in an attack spell involving wind. Hmm. Attack goes down. I'm doubtfully gonna go down for Douglas as well. Let me try it with him for a little while. See if it's, it has a wind effect of some kind. Let's test it out. These beaten are about to be beaten. Now I don't want to use his, there's just a single eye in the middle? I thought it was like a face. Alright, I don't want to use his finishing move because I want him to try out his sword. So we'll save that. Yeah. I didn't see any wind thing happen. Might just be considered part of the attack strength or something. We do not need this stuff. Alright, what's to the south? Anything? Oh, nothing. Good dungeon music. You know, mysterious sounding. It's where we can't open the barrels. Switch swords back. We do not need it. No, man. No. Yeah, I don't know how much good that sword is. Miles says, wait. Listen to that sound. What is it? Says Avin. Oh, yeah. That's the bell I got from my father, I'm sure. They must be in this cave, says Douglas. They use blowgun darts coated with a sleeping agent. We should take them out fast so they don't have a chance to use them. Well, I guess they're up that way. What's this way, then? A chest. Another reeb leaf. Okay. Saving. Blowgun shooter says, it has a nice sound. It's music to my ears. Hatchet man says, it's important loot. Put it away. If something happens to it, we'll get in trouble with Fatima. Blowgun shooter says, the boss wants that cob is something we took from the kid, right? Maybe I can keep this bell myself. Hatchet man says, don't forget the rule of the Siam Seal gang. All the loot should be sold for cash to fund our activities. We're different than those cheap bandits. But... Hi! Hey, you! Says the shooter. Douglas says, we're adventurers from the guild. Give up, you burglars! Avin says, so you're members of the Siam Seal gang. Have you been stealing here, you cheap thieves? Shut up! Says the hatchet man. We'll take you down. We've been saving up our special attack, so I'm afraid you're doomed. Oh, he's the one who doesn't have it. There's a blowgun shooter, hatchet man A. Little attack, hatchet man A. And then a flamethrow on the blowgun shooter. And a sword wind on hatchet man B. Are you still alive? Yeah, at least it took one of them out. Okay, so Hatchet Man B is very damaged compared to the other one, so... Everyone on Hatchet Man B. Nice. One left. Makes the battle a lot easier. Takes care of that. Sweet. Oh, we got a forest cape. Douglas says, "Whew! That was a tough fight. I remember. It was him. This is your bell, right?" Douglas handed Guardian Bell to Mile. "Thank you, Douglas." "So, where are the other treasures?" "Tell the truth, or I will hurt you." We haven't heard him already. "Ugh." The shooter says, "The treasure box is in the back." "Good boy." "Arf." I guess this is the back. Oh. Lots of treasure boxes. Douglas says, this is a strange-looking ornament. What do you find, Cabessa? Is this yours, Avin?" "Yeah, it's Cabessa. I'm relieved. They took back Cabessa. The last item is the Thunder Sword." He's still looking for it. Won't find it. Oh boy. "What's wrong?" says Mile. "I can't find the Thunder Sword." Oh, here he goes. "Hey, wake up!" Hatchet Man says, "Huh? Oh, what did you do with my sword? Where is the Thunder Sword I got from Master Castle?" "The sword? Oh, that giant one. I sold it already." "What? Whom did you sell it to?" "A merchant named Garcia." "Garcia? Oh, great. Who's Garcia?" asks Avin. Miles says, "I remember a merchant by that name in the capital." Douglas says, "He's infamous as a corrupt merchant. He deals in many stolen goods." "Aha," says the Hatchet Man. "Serves you right. Your sword must have been sold off already. Shut up and go back to sleep." Oh boy, knocked him back out. Damn. "Avin, Mile, I need you two to do me a favor. Can you inform the guild about these guys? I must recover my sword at once." "That's fine," says Avin. "What about the bounty?" asked Mile. "I didn't take the job for money. You can have it. I'm leaving these guys to you. That's the least I can do." "All right then. I hope to work with you again." Douglas left the party. "Yeah, I hope so too, because I bought you chainmail." Avin says he's gone. He was in such a hurry. Mile says, "But Douglas is a great fighter. He'll cut off those monsters in no time." "Yeah, no wonder he's known as a skillful adventurer. I wish I had the time to learn his sword technique." "We're all adventurers," Mile says. "I'm sure we'll see him again somewhere." "By the way, I didn't know there were remnants of the Siam Seal Gang," Avin says. "Do you think they were following Fatima's orders to steal the treasures?" Mile says, "We better report that to the guild, too." Good, we didn't have to run back ourselves. Meister says, "Good work. We handed those guys to the king's army. The army will question them about their relationship with the Siam Seal Gang. This is your fee for catching the bandits." 500 rows. Not bad. "Thank you very much," says Mile. "I feel sorry for Douglas," says Avin. "We got back our stolen items and even received payment." "Don't worry about the payment," says the Meister. "He is by far the top earner among all adventurers." Mile says, "Douglas must be a really famous adventurer. His teacher was a man we called Castle. Frank Castle? The Saint of the Swords. He was known as the best swordsman in Elfilden. Gawain, the Sage of Power, was the only one to ever match Castle when he was alive. Douglas inherited Castle's technique, That's why many clients want to use him. Avin says, I didn't know he had such a great teacher. Hey, Meister, a man's voice says. Oh, Mayor Doyle. Is anything wrong? You came running. The mayor says, I heard that the highway bandits were caught, so I came here to say thank you. Have the adventurers who caught the bandits left already? Nope. They are right beside you, Mayor. The Meister says, meet Avin and Mile, the duo who caught the bandits. Meister, don't fool me. How can these young boys be adventurers? Here we go again. Meister says, they didn't catch the bandits on their own, but I assure you they are adventurers from the guild. Do you know of the siege in Tibri? These two young men made a great contribution to the peaceful resolution of that incident. Really? Oh, well. Avin, Mile, I thank you for catching the highway bandits. I was concerned that the visitors coming from the Eden Festival might be attacked. We didn't do much, says Avin. We had our own reason for catching those guys, and we did have help. You are such a humble young man. Wait, he is perfect. You are young, but you have a strong build. Well, he may be the one. Avin says, what are you talking about, sir? Oh, I'm sorry. Avin, I need to ask a favor of you. Would you please represent Boren in the water match? The water match? The water match is the last event of the Eden Festival. On the last day of the festival, the representatives of the two towns fight on the stage constructed over Tabar River. It is said that the winning town will be blessed by the spirit Eden for the next year. Avin says, wow, but it's just... these representatives have such an important role. It's too much for me to shoulder. The mayor says, we interviewed many who are proud of their strength, but we haven't found anyone that we think can win yet. The festival is approaching, and we haven't decided on who to send yet. This will be a job order to the Adventurer Guild, and we will pay you a fee regardless of the outcome of the match. Meister, are we breaking any rules of the guild here? No, we have no problem on our side. It's up to this young man. The mayor says, what do you think? Please help the town of Boren. Please represent us in the water match. Avin says, but we're in the middle of our journey. Mile says, Avin, can I talk to you in private? What is it, Mile? It's a good opportunity. If you're in the match, people will know your name. Emel may hear it too. I don't think so, but that's just me. Mile says, everything has a purpose. The mayor is desperate too. Well, I can't force you, but if you think you can do it, I think you should. Avin says, you know how to manipulate people, don't you? Alright, if I can be of any help, I'll gladly represent the town. Oh, you will? Thank you. I am glad I asked. I will personally pay for the accommodation and meals during your stay until the festival. Have a good rest and reserve your energy. Avin says, oof, I think I got myself into big trouble. Mile says, this kind of unexpected event is the true thrill of traveling. We have to stay in Boren until the festival. How do you want to kill time? Well, let's see. Why don't we think about it over a meal? We haven't eaten anything since we caught the bandits. The Meister says, there's a cafeteria on the first floor of the inn. Mayor Doyle will pay for it, so money is no object. Eat to your heart's content. Just make sure you don't overeat, then you won't be able to move fast, and you may end up losing the match. The water match. It's an honor to be a contender. Do your best to make the people of Boren proud. I'll be cheering you on. Alright, before we go to the... to eat, let's check in with these people, see if they have anything new to say. I don't think he would. Well, the mayor's in here. Sure, he'll have something new to say. Tell the lunch lady to bring you your favorite dishes. Order as much as you want. I must go and run some errands. I own the inn, so feel free to ask for whatever you want. Oh, wow. I never walked around here. Not saying anything new, are they? Nope. Oh, these kids weren't here before. Chitta says, Teehee-hee, I came to see the Eden Festival with Kukri. When is the festival starting? Is this Kukri? Yep. Are you an adventurer by any chance? Yes, says Avin. How did you know? My elder brother was an adventurer, so I can tell. Well, I have a question. Do you know if an adventurer named Douglas is in town? Oh, Douglas. I don't think he came back to Boren yet. Oh, where is he wandering about? I wonder where Douglas is wandering about. Has he found it? Yeah, we won't answer that. You don't deserve to know. Some new kids over here. Tony says, the festival is entertaining and I love it a lot, but it costs money to have fun. Is there any way I can make money easily? You can go sell yourself on the street corner. Gratz says, New Boren hasn't decided on their representative yet, but Mayor LeBrand wants to hire an adventurer. I hear Boren is also sending an adventurer, so I guess it will be an exciting match. Even says, I really hope that will be the case. Now he just sells potions. I don't think he would say anything new. We lost a newborn in the water match at last year's Eden Festival, so we want to win this year by all means. I'm gonna pick on this poor kid again. The company will be closed during the festival. I wish the boss had told us earlier. I've been working hard so that I could take a day off to go to the festival. I feel I've wasted my energy. By the way, I hear we have a young adventurer representing the town in the water match this year. I wonder who will be the representative of New Boren. I can't wait to see. I'm looking forward to the festival, so much so that I'm working really hard. Well, at least I didn't get yelled at this time. His boss is a real jerk. Oh, is this where they're serving the food? Yeah. Oh, that's her. We have to talk to her. Let's go check around first. They're not gonna have anything new to say. Oh, that's the, okay, never mind. This is the only place we haven't gone. Let's just check upstairs. Avin, Mile, I heard. You caught the bandits, right? Good job. Thanks to you, says Mile. What are you saying? I didn't do anything. You did it yourselves. Oh, we were giving rarest potion? This is a gift from me. Look after your health. Dr. Bandle, thank you so much, says Avin. By the way, Avin, you are taking part in the water match, aren't you? You are quick-eared, Dr. Bandle. Haha, I just overheard the mayor make a booking for you at the inn. It's too bad. I must leave now. I see, says Mile. Thank you for everything. You'll continue your journey, right? I'm sure we'll meet again somewhere. So long, you two. Do look after your health. Rarest potion. Wow. That's probably like a, complete heal. Restores, yeah, hit points completely. Sweet. You get rewarded for going around talking to people and seeing what new things they have to say. Mayor Doyle informed me about you. You can stay here free. Please take a good rest. Please come to the counter to sign your name. Alright, we will rest. And then go eat. Awesome. Lance says, "Hey, you were that flower boy." Miles says, "Oh, I remember you. The couple fighting in Filden. Oh, that's them? Here? Okay, cool. We made up, thanks to you, and came to have fun at the festival. Right, darling?" "Yes, we're going to have fun, honey." Lance whispers, "Thank you so much for helping me out of that jam. Here's a token of appreciation and the money for the flowers. Please take it." "Sweet, you just got 100 roses." "Are you sure?" says Mile. "Don't be shy, just take it." So he's whispering, but totally keeping a secret to his wife that he's giving away this money. Doesn't seem very honest. "They're so full of themselves," says Mile. Oh, they just... they're not individuals. "So you are representing Borin in the water fight this year. You have a handsome face, young man. The mayor told me about you. You can stay and eat here free until the festival. How about grabbing a bite to eat in the cafeteria? My wife's cooking is the best in the world." "That's great," says Avin. "I'm famished." "Yeah," says Mile. "We used up all our energy to catch the bandits." Old Man Jaren says, "It's been 6 years since I came to Borin to see the festival. I haven't enjoyed the water match here in a long time. New Borin was having difficulty selecting their representative. I wonder if they've decided. I hear Borin's representative is an adventurer. I wish I could meet him before the match." You just did. Does not wish to give himself away. "The food here is not bad." Same thing. Didn't say anything new. Alright, well, we're gonna get some free food. Not a rare arcanum, special arcanum, whatever. We don't need that. Next episode, guys, they will eat up for free, and we'll see what happens as far as the water match, possibly. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.